Jungian was a Western psychoanalyst. His work has had a huge impact on our understanding of the mind and of human culture. Jung's most famous theory is his theory on archetypes. Archetypes are characters that show up again and again in stories all around the world that everyone seems to relate to and understand. For example, there is the trickster archetype. The Wikipedia description of the trickster is as follows. Tricksters can be cunning or foolish or both. The trickster openly questions, disrupts, or mocks authority. Often, this breaking of rules takes the form of tricks or thievery. They are often male characters and are fond of breaking rules, boasting, and playing tricks on both humans and gods. In My Little Pony, the trickster figure is quite clearly found in the character of Discord. Our very first view of Discord shows him breaking the established rules of the world. As easily as snapping his fingers, Twilight's failsafe spell instantly fails. Princess Celestia no longer has the power to protect the elements, and Discord appears in a stained glass window, mocking and criticizing Celestia for turning him into stone. Throughout the series, he constantly disrupts the plans of others and, even after being redeemed, continues to form his own plans. Outside of any other authority, it is interesting to note that tricksters in mythology can be either hero or villain, and Discord is a character who often flips between these two roles. There are many other archetypes, such as the Wise Sage, and the one thing they all have in common is the idea that many different characters through a mythology can take on their roles. This idea of roles that can be taken on by many different characters is a common one in the series, the most obvious example being the elements of harmony. Each element can only be used by a certain type of character, and it is revealed that there are times in history where new bearers of the elements are found. This fits in perfectly with Jung's theory that archetypes exist as pre-existing templates for characters and people to identify with. Jung also believed that most people have their personality split into three parts, the persona, the self, and the shadow. The persona represents the version of people that they show to everyone else, the self represents who we think we are, and the shadow represents the part of our personality we hide from ourselves. Because we are ashamed of it, Jung argued that the healthiest way to deal with the shadow element of ourselves was to accept it as a part of us and not to keep it hidden. Because if we continued to hide and deny it, then it would take over and do even more harm. Jung called this self-actualization. In the episode Do Princesses Dream of Magic Sheep, Princess Luna, who had previously attempted to take over Equestria, reveals that she has created a spirit known as a Tantabus in order to punish herself. The Tantabus grows and grows until it takes the form of a huge shadowy monster. Luna only admits this when it manages to escape into the real world and pose a serious threat to Equestria. Luna accepting this as part of her own past and admitting it, and yet still being able to have control over who she really is what causes the Tantabus to shrink from a giant monster. This is a perfect representation of Jung's ideas on the shadow and how to accept it. In his own words, this integration cannot take place and be put to a useful purpose unless one can admit the tendencies bound up with the shadow and allow them some measure of realization. This leads to disobedience and self-disgust, but also to self-reliance, without which individuation is unthinkable. Thank you for listening to this video. If you learned anything interesting, please feel free to like and to subscribe.